dog there, you add triple dog dog, because I know she pussies. I'm like, you ain't gonna do it, girl. So I'm telling her, I'm like, go ahead, go do it. Oh, you dare me to slam the door in Nicole's face. And I'm like, okay, Nicole is type pussy.
Me, but I couldn't do it all alone. We, Young Money raised me, grew up out in Paisley, Southside Jamaica, Queens, and it's crazy, cause I'm still hood, Hollywood couldn't change me. Shout out to my haters, sorry that you couldn't faze me. Ain't being cocky, we just vindicated, best believe that when we...
Okay, guys, so hey, you know, I know you probably came from my other video or whatever, but this is a story time video. So this story time is about my high school. Something that just happened to me in high school like a couple of weeks ago. So basically what happened was I was friends with this girl, whatever, and I'm gonna name her Brittany. I was friends with Brittany. Me and Brittany's very close. We're friends since sophomore year. I'm a junior now. And so we, you know, know each other pretty well. We turn each other over, turn each other on, make each other bad, da da da. Mind you, me and Brittany have arguments all the time, da da da. And we make up in one day, you know what I'm saying? So Brittany was talking mess about these other two girls. Brittany was talking about Katie and Ashley. How am I using such white people names? Okay, Brittany was talking about Bonk. Brittany was talking about Tasha. Yeah, Brittany was talking about Tasha, and she was talking mad smack about Nicole. Brittany was talking smack about Nicole and Tasha. Mad smack to me. I'm cool with Tasha, but me and me and Nicole wasn't that close anymore. Me and Nicole wasn't cool anymore for whatever reason. Nicole wanted to stop messing with me for whatever reason it was. So, but me and Tasha was so cool, but me and Nicole was not cool anymore. She stopped talking to me for whatever reason. I really didn't care because, like, what else? So, mind you, okay, so Tasha and Nicole mad close. Me and Brittany mad close. So, you know, that clashes, and then, you know, people don't like each other, and then they friends with the y'all know how it go. So let me tell you what happened. So me being a ride or die friend that I am, always riding for my friends, you feel me? So push came to shove, Brittany was talking about Tasha and Nicole on Snapchat the day before, right? So let me tell you, so the day before that, well, that night, that's what she was talking about. But in the day during school, we was all in class. It was me, Brittany, and Tasha in the class. We all have ninth period together, right? So, what's it called? So, Brittany came to me like, you did, because Nicole came to the door to wait for Tasha for the bell to ring. So, everybody could go home. She was sitting there waiting for her for the bell to ring so they could go home together or leave, whatever, whatever. So, Nicole waiting for Tasha, you know, but as I said, we were cool with Tasha. Well, I was cool with Tasha, and Brittany had a problem with Tasha and Nicole. I just like had a little like problem with Nicole, cause I don't know, it wasn't a problem, but we just stopped talking. I don't know why. You know what I'm saying? So so Brittany came to me like, you dare me to slam the door in Nicole's face. And I'm like, okay, Brittany is type pussy. Because that's the one who came to me. My friend, my close friend, Brittany. Brittany came to me like, oh, you dare me to slam the door in Nicole's face? And I'm like, okay, Brittany, you pussy. I'm like, sorry, somebody talk to me. So Brittany like, Brittany like, oh, you dare me to slam the door in Nicole's face? I'm like, I double door. Go do it. And yeah, so surprisingly, Brittany really got up and slammed the door in Nicole's face. So me, once she did that, I was like, oh, you brave, Ray. Oh, you brave, Ray. You brave, Ray. So Nicole, soon as she hear the door slam, she gets up. She comes in the class. She like, who the hell just slammed the door up in my face? And, what's her name? Tasha, the one that I'm still cool with. Tasha looking at Brittany like, did you just slam the door in my friend's face? So me, I'm saving Brittany from getting her butt beat. So I'm like, Brittany, let's go. Just go. Just go. You did what you did. You slammed the door. That's it. So they calling her. They like, Brittany, Brittany, you brave? I'm slapping Brittany. And Brittany about to turn around like, oh, yeah, I slammed the door in. Well, she just said, she like, I slammed the door. But she was about to say, slap me, slap me. I'm like, no, Brittany, just keep moving because they're going to hit you. So let's go. Me being a good friend, you know what I'm saying? I don't want my friend getting beat up, you know what I'm saying? So. So. Hours later, we get home. And so I put on my Snapchat after hours and hours. Because I just had, I forgot I had happened. So I go on my Snapchat and I write, mind you, follow me on Snapchat, guys, if you don't. OffGuard_Lord. And I said, oh, Brittany is gangster. She just been hanging out with me for too long. Because she turning gangster. Mind you, she's not black. She's Guyanese. So I'm just like, Nicole and Tasha are both black, but she's Guyanese. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like, I'm just in my, I'm just like, okay, you brave, you know? So then Nicole, the one that she slammed the door in her face, that's Nicole, the one who got, the door slammed in her face by Brittany, she slides up on my snap like, oh, and she could get slapped acting like you too. I didn't respond back. So, of course, I told my friend Brittany, oh, this is what Nicole said. She will slap you. So just keep a heads up because she said she's going to slap you. Period. That's just being a good friend. So, hold on. So, what's it called? So, what's her name? Brittany's talking mad smack that night. Mad smack. Oh, I wish Brittany's talking mad smack. Like, I wish Nicole would touch me. I wish Tasha would touch me. See what's gonna happen if they touch me. Da, 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 da. All that smack. Brittany is talking to me. So I'm just in my mind like, No. I'm like, okay. But then on the inside, she gets scared. And she tells me, she's like, oh, I don't know what to do. Cause should I report it? I might do whatever you feel gotta do. If you wanna report them, you do that. Cause in my school, if you get reported a certain amount of times, you eventually get like suspended. Cause it goes in your record, then they have to come talk to you, and if you get reported again, it's like, oh, so you didn't listen to what I said, so now you're gonna be suspended, cause you didn't want to listen to nothing I told you the first time, right? So she says she's gonna tell our teacher. So I'm looking at him, I'm in my mind, I'm like, how you gonna talk smack to them, slam the door in one of their faces, and then when they come at you, you have a problem, you can't do that. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like, listen, I'm your friend, whatever you choose to do, I support you 100%. Try to be a good friend, supporting her on the choice she makes. Try to support her, be a real good friend. So I'm supporting her. I'm like, you want to report it? Okay, we can report it. That's what we can do. If that makes you feel better, go ahead, you do it. You know what I'm saying? So, as I was saying, so that's what happened. So the night of her slamming the door in their face, she was getting all worked up, saying, oh, what is this? Oh, she don't report this, she don't do this, she don't do that. Then the next day, I think that was a Wednesday. Yeah, because we was going on break, a 4-day weekend or something like that on Wednesday. Oh, for Thanksgiving break, that's what it was. And that same day, I was going to see Nicki Minaj. Nobody was going to stop me from seeing Nicki Minaj. I don't care. No one was going to stop me. Mind you, what happened? That happened on Tuesday. The next day, wait, did it? I forgot how it happened. That happened on Tuesday. Yeah, that happened on Tuesday. Then the next day, Brittany did not go to the locker room, right? So, she didn't want to go to the locker room because we had locker room fifth period. Me, Brittany, Nicole, and Tasha, all of us had locker room at fifth period. Brittany did not want to go. She was scared out her mind. And you could tell she was. She tried to act all tough, but she was scared out her mind. She says to me, oh, I'm like, where are you? Because I go to the locker room. And then Nicole and Tasha asking me, where's your friend? So, of course, she not here. I'm defending her to the max, saying, okay, she not here, but she coming. So, in my mind, I'm like, she's probably not coming. So, I'm calling her, like, where you at? She's like, oh, I went to the office to get something to eat from our teacher, one of our teachers that we have. She went to him to go get some snacks. And I'm blacking on the phone like, when didn't you go to get snacks? You scared. You don't want to go to the locker room. But it's okay. Calm. Like, just come to the locker room. Because you got to do it anyway. Because in the beginning of the period for gym, you have to go to the locker room. Then when they let you out 5 minutes before the period end, and you go back to the locker room again and change back to your regular clothes. We have dance room. Me and Brittany and them two, Nicole and Tasha, they had a different gym. We had the dance room. But we all go to the locker room at the same time. So we all have some type of physical education at that same period, right? So she's getting aggravated. She's like, oh, I don't want to come in there, blah, blah, blah. And they still ask me, where's your friend, why she not here? She went to slam the door in people's face, right? So I'm defending her, like, yeah, she slammed the door in your face, but hey, it's done. Like, if you really wanted to hear her, you would have hit her then. You know what I'm saying? She walked right past you out the door. I'm defending her like a good friend would. And that's my problem. I'm too loyal to these girls, I swear. So, I go to the dance room where me and Brittany have dance at, you know, with physical education. And she's getting mad at me like, oh, you're trying to force me to go there, da, da, da. I'm not trying to force you to go there. It's better to deal with your problems head on. It's better to deal with your problems, right? So, because you're avoiding them by not going to the gym, the locker room, you're going to see them in the hallway. They're going to address you about what you did. You're going to see them maybe going up or down the stairs. They're going to address you. I know they are. Especially Tasha. Me and Tasha have been cool. We knew each other since freshman year. I know how she is. She's going to address you as soon as she see you. Especially you lacking by yourself. You're not going to be with me. So if you say something stupid, I can't even fix what you said. Because they're going to be there and it's just poof, slap. That's it. Like, I'm trying to help you. It's better to deal with it. Don't drag it out by making them find you or look for you or something like that. Because that's going to make them even more pissed. You did what you did. You slammed the door. You was talking smack last night. Address it. Period. Don't be scared now. You did all that talking mess, to me. So do it to them now. Period. So she finally goes to the locker room with me. And this other little skinny girl, whatever. Her friend. And I bring her to the locker room, and Nicole and Tasha just attack, like, not hit her, but like attack, like as soon as she walk in, they jump up in her face and start yelling. I'm like, whoa. Then the other friend, Nicole and Tasha's third friend, they start yelling at Brittany, and I'm just like, hold on, it's three of y'all, it's one of her, y'all not gonna sit here and yell at her. I'm not letting that rock, that's my friend. Regardless of what she did, that's my friend. You're not going to sit here and yell at her one time. I mean, no, me, of course, being a good friend. Helping her. Defending her. This is Nicole. Tasha. And this is me. And this is Brittany. My leg is literally saving Brittany's life. Because Tasha was ready to beat her up. And I have my leg in between both of them. I'm like, bro, Tasha, chill. She's like, Shania, I have so much respect for you. I'm not going to jump over you to hit her. But she got it coming. You know what I'm saying? And I understand that. And then so, Brittany, my friend, she she starts apologizing a lot because it's so loud, it draws a big group of all the girls in the locker room start coming and surrounding. And so Brittany's like, oh, I apologize for slamming the door in your face and saying what I said on Snap. And of course, I'm going to defend her at that moment. I'm not going to black on her in front of a whole bunch of people. So, yeah, I'm just not going to do that. I'm not that type of friend. I'm going to be on your side in public, and in private, I'm going to address exactly what you did wrong. So, they send me arguing, and I'm defending her, have my hand in the middle so nobody hit her, because I know she can't fight. I know she won't fight. So, after that, after the whole thing was over, after she apologized, we walk out, and I ask her, I'm like, was you scared in there? She's like, no. I'm like, you were scared. I seen it in your face. You know you were scared. And she's like, no, I wasn't. I'm like, was you scared, Brittany? She's like, yeah, I was scared out of my boots. I was like, I know you was. I could see it in your face, and I know they probably saw it too. That's probably why they was acting like that, because they know you were scared. So then I addressed what she said. I'm like, why did you apologize for slamming the door and making it seem like you didn't do what you did and say what you said? Why would you do that? And she's like, oh, I just did it because of that. I'm like, no, you stand your ground. Stand your ground. You said what you said. Period. Don't change it now because you're in front of them. You don't do that. You know what I'm saying? So then I'm just like, it's just mind-boggling. Like, so I'm just like, all right, whatever. Right? So I leave early that day. That was a Wednesday. I left early that day to see Nicki Minaj, who this look is inspired by, to go see my mover, my everything, my favorite, my queen, the queen of rap. I left early to go see her. You know, I'm having a great day. I took so many pictures with Nicki. If you didn't see that video of Mimi and Nicki, I'm going to leave that down below so you can see the video of Mimi and Nicki Minaj and how my reaction was. It was amazing. I love her. I love you, Nicki. Love you, Nicki Minaj. If you've not seen the video, I love you. You guys see on my Instagram. I love you. I post you all the time. Yeah, anyways, so I left early to go see her. Having a good day, but enjoying my Thanksgiving break. So let me tell you what this girl did. On Thanksgiving, I don't usually post friends because I don't have that many. Number one. Number two, you make people feel bad. Number three, I just don't like posting friends. You know what I'm saying? Now, if you post me, I'm definitely going to post you back. That's just how I roll. But otherwise, I would just post my families. Half the time, I only post them. I posted my nieces and my nephews. Let me tell you what Brittany did. Mind you, I saved her from an A-whooping. She posted this white girl that I'm going to slap very, very soon. I'm going to slap very, very soon. Very, very soon. Very soon. She posted some white girl named Tanya. And she posted the other girl that was in the locker room that didn't do nothing. She would have got slapped. She posted them too. Say, I'm thankful for the gang. You thankful for the gang, bitch? The gang? Stupid. Hold on, I gotta play that again. Them two saying things for the gang, but I saved you from getting beat up. Mind you, me and Tasha are friends too, and I went against her. And to defend you from getting beat up. And you post them? Is it because I'm black? I don't know. It's always been like a race thing with her. She always say, oh, these black girls. That's what she was saying. She was like, oh, these black girls is attacking me. I'm like, why you gotta always bring race into something? So I don't know if she's a racist or not. Brittany, I'm talking about. I don't know. I really, really don't know. But let me tell you, I'm enjoying my day with Nicki Minaj. On Wednesday, I come back Monday to some bull, right? So number one, she didn't say she was thankful for me. Two, she didn't say thank you for helping her. But as my friend, she shouldn't have to say thank you. Because I was supposed to do that as her friend anyway. I didn't have to, but as a friend, you help your friend. So I didn't really expect her to say thank you for that. But at least say thank you, because I saved your life. Saved your life. So number two, you didn't post you thankful for me, number one. Number two, you didn't say thank you for helping you at all. Number three, I come to school Monday, and that, like, really hurt my feelings. Like, it hurt. Let me tell you. It hurt to know. It hurt to come to school and find out that she wrote a statement on me. And I had to find out from Nicole, somebody who ain't even, me and her not even cool. My own friend didn't even text me and tell me, oh, we had a mediation on Wednesday when you left. They was looking for you. Nicole and Tasha had to tell me. And they not my close friends. Brittany is. Regardless of, she knew I was mad at her because she had texted me. She was thankful for me. It's not about the text. You posted them, but didn't post me. I can see if you texted everybody. But you just text me, but can't post me. It may seem petty to y'all, but it means a lot to me. That you posted them, but they couldn't post me. It means a lot. If you really think about it, like, come on. You know what I'm saying? So, she realized that because I left her on scene. So, she already knew I was mad at her. But regardless of that, you should have told me. That they were saying Deans was looking for me. And you know I'm on a good path. You know I haven't been involved in no drama for a long time. You know I got this DA internship. And you risked that by putting me in it and writing a statement on me. Freaking, I come to school and Nicole and Tasha tell me, oh, you know Brittany said you set her up and she wrote a statement on you. So to me, I'm just like, a statement on me, the one who jumped in between a fight that could have been happening for you, sticking up for you, always sticking up for you every time you got a problem, always sticking up for you, the one who listen and hear you when you cry about what's going on in your life, to your fam, about your family, about your suicidal thoughts. Not saying that there's anything wrong. I'm not going against anybody that has thoughts like that or anything with depression. But I listen to all this stuff about you. And I'd be there for you, buy you food when you're hungry. When I'm on my way to school, because you know I don't have a first period, I'm buying you food. Going to ask if you need something from the store. Saving you? Like, what? And you write a statement on me saying I set you up. I forced you to go down there so they could attack you. Baby girl, if I wanted them to sit there and attack you, I would just brought you down there and left you. Just stood and watched. I did not. I jumped right in between you and Tasha. So as soon as I found that out from Nicole and Tasha, they told me, of course, I'm not going to see nobody let me sweat. I say, wow, really? I call Brittany, and best to believe, I blacked on her. I call, ask her a couple questions. Oh, before I tell you what I asked her, I said on the phone. They tell me, oh, you know, the reason why we was looking at you funny in the locker room, I'm like, why? Oh, because Brittany was talking about you to us when y'all was mad at each other. Now, if you're my friend, I don't care how mad you are at me, you don't talk about me to the enemy. Period. Because at one point, Nicole and Brittany were cool. Too. When Nicole started talking to me, she was still talking to Brittany. I didn't have no problem with that. You talk to them, I'm not going to control who you're friends with. You want to still talk to Nicole, even though she's not talking to me? Fine. But she was like, oh, yeah. She was saying, oh, F, Shania, I don't even care about her no more. Da-da-da-da. You was talking mad smack about me. So I call her. I said, the first question was, you said I set you up? You wrote a statement on me? Asking all these questions. You was talking about me? And that hurt the most. You was talking about me to the enemy? And I just defended you? And you didn't even come tell me yourself you were saying stuff? I had to find out from somebody I'm not even cool with to know that Dean was looking for me? And you wrote a statement on me saying I set you up? Really, Brittany? And I asked, I'm like, what you talking about me now? She's like, no. I'm like, why would they lie? I'm gonna ask you again. You talking about me to them? Oh, yeah, I was, but it was out of anger, Shania. It's just like, and you can understand why I was hurt and where it's coming from. Yes.
As I was saying, I was really, like, you guys will understand how hurt I was. Like, I was upset, hurt, angry, all that in one. Like, why did you write a statement on me? The one that jumped in the fight for you. Well, it wasn't a fight, but they was going to hit you when I jumped in. So they cut it. And you write a statement on me, say I set you up? You questioning my loyalty, my character. I would never, ever, ever. If I wanted them to hurt you, I would have left you there. It's dumb. Like, you dumb little bitch. You dumb. You stupid. Real stupid. But I don't understand. Then the next day after she made all them excuses like, oh, I was mad at you, da da da. That's why I said what I said, da da da. Like, no, bitch. No. Real friends don't do that. Talk about each other to the enemy. Hell no. Hell no. So, yeah, so I just ended it all on the phone with her. I was like, listen, you're a horrible person, a horrible friend, and you're not somebody I need in my life. So I told her on the phone, and that was it. So the next day, I come to school. In my school, you got your ID, so you got to swipe to get in. Tell me why I get buzzed. Like, I swipe, and I walk right in. Like, that's how you do it. The guy like, come here, miss. I come back and I swipe again because I thought like it didn't take because sometimes they be like come back to swipe again. He like, no. He's like, and I'm looking on the screen and says, do not admit with like red capital letters. That's only like if you one of those bad kids and you like did something wrong and you left school so you ain't get in trouble, but they put something on your name so when you come in, they do find you. You can't just walk in. So a whole bunch of deans come get me and I'm looking like, Men in Black type stuff, they coming out of different rooms. I'm like, hold on. They're like, Shania, I'm not saying my last name, but they're like, Shania, da da da. Come with me. I'm like, where am I going? He's like, oh, you have to go to the room to go see the person who put a block on your name. And it was to find out, it was about this stupid situation with Brittany, Nicole, and Tasha. I'm like, he's like, oh, so what did you do? You were instigating the whole thing and blah, blah, blah. You set her up. I'm like, no, mind you, that's my college now professor. So that changes his perception of me. He think I'm out here setting people up and stuff like that. And that's not even what it was. He's like, oh, Brittany said you did this. Brittany said you did this. Brittany said you did that. I'm like, listen, Brittany could suck my dick. Suck my dick, like, at this point, and it's just like, you do me wrong, and I was nothing but good and nice to you. Nothing but good. But you, one, don't say thank you for what happened on Wednesday. Two, you don't even let me know Dean's is looking for me. You don't even let me know what's in the loop. Three, you don't even post me on freaking Thanksgiving, but you post those two girls that wasn't even there for you. When you say you wanted to kill yourself, they wasn't even there. Four, you say I set you up questioning my loyalty and my character. My character? Now, if I wanted to fight you, I'd be an angry black girl, right? As you would say, an angry black girl, right? But no, now I'm just going to make your life a living hell. That's just how I am. Whatever I got to do, if it's... And if you watch this video, just know you can suck my dick. And I hate you, like I said. So, with that being said, this story time and conclusion, it teaches you guys, everybody ain't your goddamn friend. Don't be friends with people, because they're going to stab me in your motherfucking back. That's basically what I got in conclusion to this video. Because that's exactly how I feel. I don't be nobody's friend now. You know what I'm saying? Feel at the moment. Don't be nobody's friend. Nobody's trustworthy. Everybody's out to get me. Everybody out to do something to me. That's exactly why I am the way I am. Because of females like that. And I was ready to beat her up. Smack her. Like, period. You lied on me. You talked about me. All of that. And I'm wondering why they looking at me like I'm crazy. Like, Shania, why you getting involved? Shania, why you getting involved with somebody that was talking about you? You look stupid. And I don't like looking stupid. But you made me look stupid. And you know I was looking stupid the whole entire time. So now I make you look stupid now, bitch. How about that? You scared to come to the locker room. Haven't been to the locker room in like a month. Like, ever since this whole thing happened, you have not been to the locker room. Don't come to the locker room. You barely come to the classes we got together because you scared. Where was all that mouth when you was talking about me, huh? Oh, you didn't think I could flip the script. Yeah, I was a sweet girl. But don't forget, I'm black, like you would say, right? I'm black. You didn't think I could get ghetto because you said I'm not like those other black girls. So now I'm ghetto to you? Am I ghetto, y'all? What y'all think? Y'all let me know. Y'all let me know. But yes, I hope you guys enjoyed this story time. And let me know if you would like more story times like this. Or any type of other story time. But that was just a little story time. Bitch is fake. Bitch is not your friends. Don't be friends with nobody. Period. Deuces.